Let's move on to another trait, osteogenesis imperfecta, OI, sometimes known as brittle bone disease. Now, people with OI are born with defective connective tissue, or sometimes without the ability to make it, usually because of a deficiency in collagen. Now, you may have heard of collagen before, and maybe even commercials or something like that, but when we talk about collagen, it's a huge and important structural protein in your cells. It's kind of what makes your skin so pliable and durable all at the same time. It serves many important structural purposes. And in the case of osteogenesis imperfecta, it doesn't work the way it normally should. Now, the incidence of OI is about 1 in every 20,000 live births. Let's take a look at our fictional individual, Sadie, who has a European-American background. And here is a fictional pedigree of Sadie's family. Here we see that Sadie is not affected by OI, but her brother, her mother, her maternal uncle, and her maternal grandmother are all affected by osteogenesis imperfecta. Now, just like we've done for the last two traits, before we get into the genetic cause here, first I want you to tell me a little bit about the inheritance pattern of OI. Based on the pedigree shown here and what you've learned about inheritance patterns, I want you to tell me if you think that this trait resembles an autosomal, sex-linked, or maternal inheritance pattern, and then I want you to identify whether or not you think it's dominant or recessive. If you have any trouble answering this, you can go back and check out lesson 5 where we first learned about pedigrees and this kind of dominance.